Joseph DeQuis.
和牛はね、約4万年か5万年前にヨーロッパから黒い牛、東南アジアとか熱帯地方からコブのある牛とか、和牛のこの斑点とか、そういう牛が中国大陸に移動してきて、3万年、4万年かけてそれらの交雑を重ねながら朝鮮半島を通って日本に渡ってきた。それで何が一番いいかっていうと、黒い牛が一番肉が取れる、サシが入る、そういうことで明治時代から黒肉を選抜しながら繁殖を始めてきた。
The Wagyu cattle were draft cattle. I think for hundreds of years, they were just essentially hauling logs out of forests and rocks out of mines. They got these big shoulders as a result.
この和牛っていうのは農耕用とか、山から木材を運んだり繁殖をしていた。で、もう一つは1300年前に、それからもう一つは他の牛にない和牛の特徴は、サシが入るってこと。
It's just been for a little over a century that the Japanese have been eating beef. So to some degree, the Japanese adopted the North American model in that they prized marbling. It's a trait that people associate with quality. All cattle have this gene, but it's tweaked in Wagyu cattle. It's a gene called Delta 9 desaturase, big fancy scientific sounding name. But essentially, this gene produces an enzyme that takes a stearic acid molecule and changes it into oleic acid. Stearic acid is saturated, oleic acid is unsaturated. This is a big deal from a nutritional point of view. This gene is super turned on in Wagyu cattle, so their beef is less saturated.
What impressed me so much about Mr. Takeda was that he told me about his vision for Wagyu, and it was beyond having the finest Wagyu, the finest beef that a human being could create. But his vision was to revolutionize the beef industry in the world through Wagyu.
いい牛が出たよって言ったら買いに行って持ってきて。だって子供を産まして肉にして割ってみる。どうしても最初の4頭の中の均等っていう牛にかなわない。それの子孫。
Mr. Takeda told me something that just really struck me. He said, Pete, he said, these genetics that you're buying from me are my genetics that for 50 plus years I've perfected in Japan. So you will have a genetic platform that is exactly what I have in Japan, and it will be extraordinary.
My birthday that year, I had 50 pregnant heifers and our first batch of Wagyu. So happy birthday, me.
Essentially, it's almost like this farm is a satellite farm of Mr. Takeda's. How we breed the animals are bred naturally, are crossed between the cows and the bulls. We get advice from Mr. Takeda. The whole diet in the finishing program has been designed by Mr. Takeda. Our barns, he had a lot of influence in a lot of counsel in how we design these barns.
This may not look all that special, but it is. Because if you look at this pen behind me, there's what, 4, maybe 5 cattle. I've been to feedlots where there are hundreds of cattle in a pen, feedlots that have more than 50,000 head of cattle in them. Some of them get up to 100,000. So this is totally unusual. This is, you're seeing artisan beef making in action right here. This is the real deal. This is what it looks like.
世界中で和牛ほど美味しい牛肉はない。 それを世界中の人に食べてほしい。ところが日本から輸出できる国、衛生協定ができてる国はアメリカ以外になかった。それでアメリカに持って。
Mr. Takeda taught me how he raises his Wagyu and how he feeds them and how he cares for them.
He probably knows as much about them as anyone that I've ever known because he's lived it and seen it all. And you can't get what he knows out of a book. It's something he's grown up with and lived all of his life.
When they're mature, they're eating probably about 15 pounds of hay a day and roughly about 15 pounds of grain. And that converts to probably about 2.5 pounds of daily weight gain. We weigh them once a month, and if you watch us weighing them, they are better behaved than most kids because they go right into the scale, they enjoy it, they come back, and they come back into their pen. Virtually 100% of the meat that is produced on this farm is of USDA Prime Plus quality.
If Prime is up here, the Japanese scale like starts right around here and goes up here. I mean, it is off the charts, literally off the charts.
If Wagyu can produce almost 100% Prime Plus, isn't that extraordinary? We have just completely changed the quality equation of beef raised in America.
ピートさんはメス牛も一流の牛を持っている。ブルーももちろん一流の牛を持っている。そしてそれをから出た子供を全部こう飼育して肉に見てる。自分の都合のいいように証言するんで、本当に学者なり技術屋がこの方法がいいよって人に勧めるんだら自分で買うべきだ。自生域がどんどん行くようになって、第一の願望である世界中の人に食べてほしいっていう願いは大体達成しています。
I think what I'm so intrigued with the Japanese approach, in particular Mr. Takeda's approach to raising cattle, is they believe in letting the animalsact like cattle.
The life that animal leads is extremely important. You want it to be in a stress-free environment for as long as possible.
You know, these animals are doing what they're naturally bred to do, enjoying the pasture, raising their babies, but that's a whole humane environment. It's a stress-free environment, and it's natural, no drugs.